In this video, I'll be showing you how to create this spiral halftone effect in Photoshop. Stay tuned to find out. So first thing you want to do is find yourself an image, and so I'll link to this image in the description below, and so you can follow along with me. And so I'm just scaling it up slightly so our eye is a bit more prominent. And so what we want to do is find the center of our artboard. And so to do this, we're going to go up to View, down to Guides, and select New Guide. And under Position for Vertical, I'm going to write 50%, and then hit OK. And we're going to do the same for our Horizontal Guide. So go down to New Guide, and this time select Horizontal, and we're going to input 50% again. Hit OK. And now where these two guides meet is the center of our artboard. And we're just going to adjust our image so the center of our eye matches that center point. Now what we're going to do is trim off the excess of our image so it matches our artboard size. So right clicking your image layer, if we scroll down, we're going to select Flatten Image. And then once you've done this, make sure to unlock your layer by double clicking it and hitting OK. And next we're going to create some duplicates of our layer. So right click your layer and select Duplicate Layer. And we're going to call this one Layer 2. And we're going to do it one more time. So right click, Duplicate Layer. And this one can be called Layer 3. And turn off your top layer so we can see the layer that we're working on. So we're going to select Layer 2. Go up to Filter, down to Blur, and select Radial Blur. And for this one, it's going to be a little bit more subtle. So maybe around 4. Hit OK, and then we're going to create a clipping mask. Select the brush tool and make sure it's set to black. And we're just going to paint out our eye. So just the center of our eye, so we've still got that radial blur around the outside. Now we're going to do the same for layer 3. So making sure that's turned back on, we're going to go up to Filter, down to Blur, and select Radial Blur. This layer is going to be a little bit blurrier. So I'm going to set the amount to maybe about 11. Hit OK. And again, we're going to create a clipping mask and paint out our main focus area of the eye. Once you're happy, select all your layers by holding Shift and click, right click, and we're going to go Duplicate Layers. Hit OK. And again, right click and scroll down. And we're going to select Merge Layers. And so with this new layer selected, let's jump up to Filter. And we're going to select Filter Gallery. And then in this panel, under the Sketch dropdown, we're going to select the Halftone Pattern. And we're going to change the pattern type to Circle. Now we can zoom out in the bottom left of this panel here so we can get a better view of our image. And we can adjust these sliders for size and the contrast. Now we're going to add another effect. So down the bottom right here, if we click this little plus button, it's going to add a new layer. And in this layer, we're going to select the graphic pen. And this is going to give it a little bit of texture. Again, you can adjust the settings to what looks best. And then hit OK when you're done. And that's how to create a spiral halftone effect in Photoshop. Just one more thing. If you want to be the first to hear about new and trending design tips, hit that subscribe button now, and as always, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.